Hey everyone, this is Jyotika and welcome to your 15th HTML5 tutorial. In the previous video, we learned about creating responsive images by providing multiple image files to the browser and letting it decide which one to load using the srcset and sizes attributes for the image element. In all the examples, we used the same photo of a cat, which was just saved as different copies with more or fewer pixels. The content and aspect ratio of the photo was the same for all the copies. But what if we wanted to use different images for a big screen and a small screen? Maybe we don't want to show this extra black part and just want to focus on the cat's face on a mobile and show the entire photo only on a desktop. Or what if we wanted a completely different photo altogether for different devices? This cannot be achieved by using the image element alone, with the srcset or sizes attributes. For this, we use the picture element. The picture element is great for solving what we call as the art direction problem. It involves wanting to change the image displayed to suit different screen sizes. For example, let's say a web page includes a large landscape shot with a bird in it. When viewed on a desktop browser. When viewed on a mobile browser, that same image is shrunk down, making the bird in the image very small and hard to see. It would probably be better to show a smaller portrait image on a mobile, which zooms in on the bird. The picture element allows us to implement just this kind of solution. It allows us to display different pictures for different devices or screen sizes. It is written just like other elements with an opening tag and a closing tag. It contains one or more source elements and one image element to offer alternative versions of an image for different screens. The source element is an empty element, meaning that it has no content and does not have a closing tag. Each source element can contain one or more srcset attributes and a media attribute. The srcset attribute, as we learned in the previous video, is used to offer a list of possible images based on size. The media attribute specifies a media condition that defines when the image is the most suitable. The browser evaluates the condition specified inside each source element, and if the source's media condition evaluates to false, the browser skips it and looks at the next element inside the picture element. This way, the browser can choose the image that best fits the current device or screen size. Here, I have created two cropped versions of this cat photo for smaller screen sizes. And now, let's go ahead and see how to write the code to display these images on different devices. Let's start by opening the animals.html page. I've already removed the earlier code to reduce the clutter on page, and I'll add it later when I send out the file. As always, you can write this code on a brand new HTML file as well. We will start with the good old image element as always, with the source, alt text, and the width and height attributes. This will be used by any browser that doesn't support the picture element. And even if you don't care about old browsers, you still have to have an image element. If you leave it out, none of this is going to work. Then let's wrap this image element with a picture element. Now we can list our different image options through the source element. I want to provide three options, so I will create three source elements here inside the picture element. But make sure to write them before the image element. Always specify the image element as the last child element of the picture element, as the browser starts reading the code from the top to bottom. And we want the browser to use the URL in the image element as a fallback option if none of the source elements match. Now, first, let's put the landscape version or the entire picture here in the first source element using the srcset attribute. We will use this version for desktops and bigger screens. Then, let's point to the slightly cropped version of the photo that we will use for devices which are bigger than mobile phones like tablets, iPads, here in the second source element. And lastly, the smallest cropped version of the image, which we will use for mobile phones in the last source element. Now we have to tell the browser when should it use which image. And that can be done by writing some media conditions. So for the first two source elements, let's write the media attribute and then min width colon 900 pixels for the biggest image and min width 650 pixels for the slightly smaller one. There's no need to write any media condition for the smallest version here. And what all this means is, when the viewport is a minimum of 900 pixels wide or bigger, the landscape version of this photo loads. When the viewport is smaller than 900 pixels but bigger than 650 pixels, the bigger cropped version loads. And when the viewport is even smaller than 650 pixels, our smallest cropped version loads. The order of your source elements inside the picture element is very important, as the browser will look for the first source element where the media condition matches the current viewport width and then ignores the rest of the elements written ahead. The selected image is then presented in the space occupied by the image element. If none of the conditions specified match or if the source element is not supported by the browser, then the image mentioned in the image element will be displayed. Similarly, you can also provide completely different images for different viewport sizes. Some browsers or devices may not support all image formats, so you can use the picture element to add images of all formats, and then the browser will use the first format it recognizes and ignores any of the following elements. So that's another way you can use the picture element. Now this srcset attribute in the source element works exactly the same way it does in the image element. That means we can apply everything that we learned in the previous tutorial in this example. So here you can see I combined our previous knowledge of the width descriptors for image sizes with the picture, source, srcset and media attribute to provide multiple file options in each srcset, telling the browser how wide each file is. The browser then swaps from one file to another, only using the bigger files when they are needed. It's taking both the viewport size and the pixel density of the screen into account. Now you might be thinking, that's a lot of math and a lot of files to create, but it's totally worth the effort. The image files for today's examples range in the size from 23 KB to 271 KB. And with the help of these picture, source and srcset, the browser downloads only the image that is the smallest and yet the best looking for a particular screen. None of the rest of the files are downloaded. Imagine if we created a web page that has 10 photos on it and saved our users 500 KB per photo. That's 5 megabytes of data we have saved. Which is the whole point, to save on downloads, save on money, and increase the performance of our website. Definitely worth doing. Now let's quickly review. The picture element contains one or more source elements, each referring to different images through the srcset attribute. This way the browser can choose the image that best fits the current view or device. Each source element can also contain a media attribute that defines when the image is the most suitable. The picture element is mostly used for art direction. That is, when you want to cut out unnecessary details in a picture and show a simpler version of it on smaller displays. Or to show a completely different picture altogether for different screen sizes. It is also used when we want to offer alternative image formats for cases where certain formats are not supported. Using the picture element can also save a lot of bandwidth and speed up the page load times, as it provides the browser a set of image options to load the most appropriate image for the viewer's display. And that's it for today. With this, we also conclude the topic of responsive images in HTML. If you haven't seen the earlier part, then I highly encourage you all to go watch it too to have an all-round view of this topic. The link for the video is above and in the description below. Also, don't forget to check the other informative links in the description where I have also put today's code. And yeah, let me know in the comments if you have any questions. This is Jyotika signing off. Until next time, keep learning and keep coding.